in the packet of handouts that we gave each of you when you came in, you have four examples of letters that we send out every year. And this is what's actually doing it right now. Essentially, at this point in time, again, with everything being on the computer, all of our records, we do analysis quite easily. We tailor the type of letter to the type of giver that we're appealing to. One letter we send out to our consistent and generous givers who make pledges and live up to them. Another there is a sample of a letter that we send out to those who give less than $100 in the course of the year, challenging them to do more. We also send out letters to those who exceed their pledge and to those who do not pledge but are consistent givers. These are all different types of letters. And at the end of January every year, we write and thank those who made pledges for so doing and give them an update of their mid-year progress toward completing their pledge, along with a statement of giving for income tax purposes. This year, we also mailed statements to those for whom we had no record of any contribution in the course of the year. And you'll have that in your packet as well. In a small parish where we like to think everybody knows your name, this can be handled easily at this point, after the initial work. This can be handled easily by one staff member who knows the congregation well, or even a single volunteer. Once you've made your case for sacrificial giving, and that has been accepted by the parish as a faithful act of discipleship, it takes hard work to get to this place. But that can be accomplished, as in our experience, within 5 or 6 years. For the rest of our time together today, we would like to entertain your comments, questions, and any success stories of your own that you'd like to share with the entire group. And we hope that our presentation was helpful to you.
Charlotte, I have one question. You mentioned at the beginning of your remarks that when you took over the leadership role at St. Vincent de Paul, you spoke to the parishioners about four things: living within our means, make sure we give a fair share to other ministries, and maintain the buildings and grounds.
And the diocese, stewardship of the diocese, as being faithful, responsible members of the diocese.